All right. Well, fire off a few more rounds before we call it. I think I'm gonna try to stick this time. Move that barricade out of the way. Shoot some sticks and see how I do. I kind of like the sticks better. I think they give me a little more stability. So, anyway, get on it.
See what we got.
Shot with sticks before, you're missing out. These are hammers, great sticks, quiet. They have an O-ring right here on these that when they fold out on all the joints, that O-ring kind of keeps them quiet. So it cuts down on some of the noise. These things they're awesome. It doesn't really take a whole lot to get used to using them. You just gotta be coordinated. If you're not coordinated, well, sorry for your luck. But they compact down to nothing. They weigh nothing. And, you know, I'll always have these on me. I put them in my hydration pouch. On the back here, you go right in there. Yeah. You can carry them around like that, put them in your pocket. These 511s have some deep pockets, so if I was running around, needed a place to store them and pull them out real quick, you could do it. These things are the bomb. I think I shoot better with them too. So, let's see if that's the case. Proof is always in the pudding. So let's find out how we do with this thing. Let me get my ears on. Alright. They're a lot more stable for me than that. All right, 200 yards. I can't see it. The bush in the way. Shit. Well, shoot through the bush and see. You can hear it. I'm whaling on that 200 plate. These are a lot more accurate than that. The only movement I really have with this is front to back, and if I've got it jammed into my shoulder, it ain't moving. Side to side, well, these kind of keep it from moving side to side, keep it from rolling. You can't argue with the sounds you're hearing. And I'm shooting through a bush. Much, much better with shooting sticks. There's no question. Even though I couldn't see that 200-yard plate very well because of the bushes, they're shooting right through it. I'm surprised. Which, you know, I probably could have hit it more. Probably would have hit it more had I not been shooting through the bushes. Now, I seem to remember looking at that 200-yard target. I don't remember seeing anything keyholing. So I don't think I really hit any bushes on the way out to it, but you never know. So I think what we're going to do is pick up, that's a brass, clean up. Been out here, done it, like it. Hang out for a little bit maybe and shoot some pistol. In fact, I think I'll bring in that 50 yarder right now and put a few rounds through the Beretta and the Ruger and find out where things are shooting. So, lots of fun though. Man, it's a beautiful, beautiful area. Totally digging it. I hope you guys are lucky enough to find a place like this. I'd love to tell you about it and love to have you come out and shoot. You can put in the comments if you live out here in Arizona and you might be interested in coming out here and shooting. I might take you up on it. I need a four-wheel drive truck. It sucks having to rent a truck every time to come out. And the road coming in and going out is not going to be bad at all. I can make it with this truck, two-wheel drive, nothing special. Radial tires, not even off-road tires. So, you know, it's pretty easy to get to this spot. I don't know if you could do it in a car. I guess you probably could. But you don't need four-wheel drive to get out to it. It just cost me, I don't think I did the 300 miles that I had asked them or told them I was going to do. So it's probably going to cost me about 120 for the day. And I don't mind so much, you know, as long at least I can get out, you know. If I couldn't get out, that would really suck. So thank God I can rent a truck and haul all my shit out here. One of these days I'll break down all of my gear, kind of show you what I do to put on a shoot like this. There's going to be some run and gun out here. This area here is going to be my new run and gun course. So there's going to be some more shooting out here on this area. I don't even know if I have to worry about coming out here during the middle of the week. I don't think I do. Or at least not right now. And if you get out here early enough, then you know, obviously you're going to be here before somebody else does. You definitely have to go up this road though and make sure there's nobody camping up there. And other than that, there's nothing. There's nothing out here. So beautiful. Awesome place to shoot. You want to come out and zero in a rifle, a couple rifles, want to come and hang out, definitely shade is required. Have to buy a easy up to hang out on, you know, with or whatever. I gotta have to shade. A couple of trees, but nothing real super shady. I guess I could go sit over there if I wanted to. But yeah, it'd be better to have a easy up. You know. Fun, fun, fun. And that's the name of that tune. So this is how I find BLM land, and this is one of the payoffs of going and doing some research. I think I scored big time on this. I can't say it enough. I'm totally stoked about this place. Absolutely stoked. This is a great spot. Can't wait to go put this video together, get it out there on the tube for you guys. Brass pickup, and then I'm gonna pick up some other asshole shit. Look at that steel case ammo. I guess if you left it out here long enough, it'd rust. But the brasser, that's not mine, but just put it over there anyway. Yeah, come by. Dude, I'm picking up some of these shells. God, that pisses me off. Seeing that. That's how we're going to lose these spots. I know I keep saying it over and over and over again. That's how we're going to lose these spots, boys and girls. You know, I could have a bunch of little kids
Well, not I wouldn't say a bunch. I can't stand a bunch of little kids. I could have a couple of little kids out here practicing with some 22, shooting, practicing gun safety, have a nice little lunch, barbecue. Shit, you could barbecue out here big time, easy. You know, make a day of it, little Sunday afternoon action. Cool, cool. I love it. Awesome. All right, well, I'm going to turn you off, and then we'll go find what that steel down there looks like. I have to drive out there because we're going to start picking up.